Good morning to all of you. We have started chapter constraint satisfaction problem. Already we have seen some of the concepts of this chapter, and today we are going to talk about the remaining concepts. In the last lecture we have seen constraint satisfaction problem. We have seen how we are going to define it, how we are going to define the constraints are, and how it is going to satisfy the constraints. After that we have seen this map coloring problem also, and after that we have seen the job scheduling problem also. So we have seen two problems. We have seen variations in the CSP also. CSP means constraint satisfaction problem. We have seen types of the constraints also. Now today we are going to talk about the constraint propagation, inference in CSP. Now inference means it is just like some kind of conclusion, or inference means some kind of decision also, we can say that. So let's talk about the inference in CSP. CSP means constraint satisfaction problem. In CSP, an algorithm can search or do a specific type of inference, and that is called as constraint propagation, using the constraint to reduce the number of legal values of a variable, which in turn can reduce the legal values for another variable and so on. It means that we have to conclude the legal values for a variable. If we conclude a legal values for a variable, we can conclude legal values for another variable also. It means if we conclude a legal value for one variable, we can conclude legal value for another variable. For example, you just take example of map coloring problem. So in case of map coloring problem, suppose one variable that is suppose South Australia, and for the South Australia I have given red color. So my legal value for the variable South Australia is red. Now the one variable has reduced. Now I can assume for the variables which are not neighbors, so for that I can assign either blue or a green. So the one red has been reduced and one South Australia has been reduced. Now I have two colors and remaining regions. So that is called as legal values for legal variable. Now from this we can talk about the node consistency. Now what is node consistency is? A single variable is a node consistent if all the values in the variable's domain satisfy the variable's unary constraint. That means unary means a single variable, single value. So a node consistent is a single variable is a node consistent. A single variable is called as node consistent when it is called as node consistent if all the values for variable's domain, means all the values of the variable domain, should satisfy the variable's unary constraint. It means the one constraint should satisfy all the values. For example, in Australia map coloring problem, when South Australia dislike green, the variable SA starts with the domain red, green, blue, and we can make it node consistent if by eliminating green, leaving South Australia with reduced domain red and blue. सध्या आपण कन्स्टंट प्रोपेगेशन हा कन्सेप्ट बघतोय. तर इन्फरन्स म्हणजे काय? इन्फरन्स म्हणजे अनुमान, म्हणजे एखादं डिसिजन किंवा एखादं कन्क्लुजन काढणे, अनुमान काढणे, याला आपण म्हणतो इन्फरन्स. तर आपल्याला समजा एखादं जर आपण अनुमान काढला, तर त्याच्यानंतर आपले व्हेरिएबल्स लागणारे लीगल व्हॅल्यूज आणि त्याचे डोमेन्स हे सुद्धा कमी होतील. तर कसे कमी होतील? तर समजा आपण नोड कन्सिस्टन्सी ठरली, ओके. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, समजा एकच व्हेरिएबल आहे एका डोमेनमधला. आता नोड कन्सिस्टन्सी म्हणजे काय? अ सिंगल व्हेरिएबल आपण नोड कन्सिस्टंट कधी म्हणणार आहे? जेव्हा सगळ्या व्हॅल्यूज, म्हणजे त्याचे डोमेन्स आहे, डोमेनमधल्या सगळ्या व्हॅल्यूज हे ॲटलिस्ट एक तरी कन्स्टंट सॅटिस्फाय करायला पाहिजेत. म्हणजे एक कन्स्टंट सॅटिस्फाय करत असेल तर त्याला म्हणायचं नोड कन्सिस्टन्सी. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, उदाहरण आपण घेतलं आहे, प्रिव्हियस एक्झाम्पल आपण बघितलं आहे मॅप कलरिंगसाठी, तर तेच एक्झाम्पल आपण इथं स्पेसिफाय करतो आहे. तर जो आपण ऑस्ट्रेलियाचा मॅप कलरिंग करणार आहे, त्याच्यामध्ये समजा साऊथ ऑस्ट्रेलियाला ग्रीन हा कलर द्यायचा नाही आहे, ओके. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, साऊथ ऑस्ट्रेलियन लोकांना समजा ग्रीन कलर आवडत नाही आहे, त्यामुळे आपण ग्रीन कलर द्यायचा नाही असं आपण अज्यूम केला, तर साऊथ ऑस्ट्रेलियासाठी दोन कलर राहतील मग, एक रेड आणि ब्ल्यू. So the variable SA starts with the domain red, green and blue, and you can make it node consistent. Node consistent kadhi asnar hai? By leaving SA with reduced domain red and blue. तर ह्याला म्हणायचं लीगल व्हॅल्यू. लीगल व्हॅल्यू म्हणजेच काय? तर जे आपण कन्स्टंट सॅटिस्फाय करणार आहे त्यासाठी आपण जो डोमेन चूज करणार आहे दॅट डोमेन शूड बी अप्लाइड इन सच अ वे दॅट द कन्स्टंट शूड सॅटिस्फाय ऑल द व्हॅल्यूज. सो दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज नोड कन्सिस्टंट. नेक्स्ट वी टॉक अबाउट द आर्क कन्सिस्टंट. A variable in a CSP is arc constant if every value in its domain satisfies the various binary constant. Binary means either one of the values. Binary means for the two values. A variable in the CSP is an arc constant if every value in its domain satisfies variable's binary constant. Means the domain or the domain's variables should satisfy at least two constraints. Now the constraints are nothing but these are the limitations that the variable should satisfy. For example, xi is an arc constant with respect to another variable xj if for every value in the current domain di there is some value in the domain dj that satisfies the binary constraint in the arc xi and xj. Now when we talk about the example, you will come to know this, how it is going to satisfy it. A network is an arc constant if every variable is arc consistent with every other variable. Now we talk about with one example. Suppose the constant is y is equal to x square. So this is the constant or this is the condition that should be satisfied, where domain of both x and y is the set of digits. Now how we can write this constraint explicitly? Now x, y. Now this is the x, 0, okay. And now the constraint is y is equal to x square. Now these are the values for x and y. So this will be the domain. We have to reduce it. So 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, 3, 9. Now to make an x arc consistent with respect to y, we reduce x domains to 0, 1, 2 and 3. So these will be the x domains. If we also make y's arc constant with respect to x, then y's domain will become 0, 1, 4 and 9, because this should be arc constant in such a way that the constant y is equal to x square should satisfy the condition. Now we talk about the path consistency. Now path consistency tightens the binary constraint by using explicit constraint that are inferred by looking at the triples of variables. A two variable set xi and xj is a path consistent with respect to the third variable xm if for every assignment xi is equal to a and xj is equal to b, the consistent with the constraint on xi xj there is an assignment to the xm that satisfies the constraints on xi xm and xm xj. So this is called as path consistency because one can think of it as looking at the path from xi to xj with xm in the middle. So the path consistency is nothing but it's an example of if a is equal to b and b is equal to c, then a is equal to c. So the b should be in the middle. So like this, xm in the middle of xi and xj. So it is called as path consistency. In case of path consistency, xm that satisfies the middle variable. So xi, xm, this will be one, and xm, xj, this will be another. So xm is the middle or xm is the common between x and xj. So a two variable set xi, xj is a path constant if it should satisfy xi, xm and xm, xj. So it should satisfy this constant, that is called as path consistent. We'll make the set wa and sa path constant with respect to nt. Now these are the values from the map coloring. These are the variables from the map coloring. We start by enumerating the consistent assignment to the set. In this case, there are only two, wa is red and sa is blue, and wa is blue and sa is red. We can see that both of these assignments nt can be neither red nor blue. तर पाथ कन्सिस्टन्सी म्हणजे काय? समजा एक व्हेरिएबल सेट असेल एक्स आय आणि एक्स जे, हा जो पाथ कन्स्टंट आहे आपण कधी म्हणू शकतो, जर त्याने कन्स्टंट सॅटिस्फाय केले ज्याच्यामध्ये एक्स आय आणि एक्स एम आणि एक्स एम आणि एक्स जे ह्याच्या व्हॅल्यू सेम असतील. दॅट मीन्स देअर शुड बी सम लिंक बिटवीन एक्स आय एक्स एम एक्स एम एक्स जे सो दॅट इट शूड सॅटिस्फाय द कंडिशन एक्स आय एक्स जे. सो दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज पाथ कन्सिस्टंट. After that, we are going to see K-consistency. Stronger forms of propagation can be defined with the notion of K-consistency. A constant satisfaction problem is a K-consistent if for every set of K-1 variables and for any consistent assignment of those variables, a constant value can always be assigned any kth variable. A CSP is strongly K-consistent if it is K consistent and is also K-1 constant, K-2 constant, all the way down to 1- consistent. It means if there are K variables and it should be consistent with all the variables, then it is called as K consistency. A global constant is one involving an arbitrary number of variables. So if there are arbitrary number of variables, it is called as global constant. For example, all difference constraint says that all the variables involved must have distinct values. It means every variable should have unique value or distinct value. It should be separate from other values. So one simple way of inconsistency detection for all difference constraint works as follows. If m variables are involved in the constraint and if they have n possible distinct values, altogether m is greater than n, then the constraint cannot be satisfied. This leads to the following simple algorithm. First, remove any variable in the constraint that has a singleton domain. It has a single domain, and delete that variable's value from the domains of the remaining variables. So, we have to delete the variable's value from the domains of the remaining variables, and we have to repeat it till there should be a singleton variable. If at any point an empty domain is produced or there are more variables than domain values left, then an inconsistency has been detected. This method can detect the inconsistency of the assignment as WA is equal to red and NSW is equal to red. So this is called as inconsistency. Now the variables SI, NT and Q are effectively connected by all different constraint because each pair must have the two different colors. So this was applied to the map coloring problem. So for every concept we are taking consideration of the map coloring. So whatever the concept we have seen, these are all attached with the map coloring problem. So there can be different solutions for a map coloring. So we are talking about each point of view. तर आपण कन्स्टंट प्रोपॅगेशन बघतोय, त्याच्यामध्ये आपण इन्फरन्स इन CSP. इन्फरन्स म्हणजे काय? तर कन्स्टंट प्रोपॅगेशन प्रॉब्लेममध्ये आपण एखाद्या अनुमानपर्यंत कसं जायचं, तर त्यासाठी जे आपण कॉन्सेप्ट बघतोय, एक ते म्हणजे बघितलं आपण नोड कन्सिस्टन्सी म्हणजे काय? तर एखाद्या व्हेरिएबलचा डोमेन हा एकाच डोमेनमधले एक व्हॅल्यू असू शकते, तर त्याला म्हणतो आपण नोड कन्सिस्टंट. उदाहरण घेतलं आपण मॅप कलरिंगसाठीचं. मॅप कलरिंगमध्ये समजा जर साऊथ ऑस्ट्रेलियामध्ये ग्रीन नको असेल, तर आपला मॅप रोड्यूस झाला दोन डोमेनसाठी, एक रेड आणि ब्ल्यू. सो नोड कन्सिस्टंट म्हणजे काय? साऊथ ऑस्ट्रेलिया डिसलाईक ग्रीन, दॅट इज नोड कन्सिस्टंट. त्यानंतर बघितलं आपण आर्क कन्सिस्टन्सी म्हणजे काय? इट शूड सॅटिस्फाय द बायनरी कन्स्टंट. उदाहरण बघितलं आपण कन्स्टंट्समध्ये वाय इज इक्वल एक्स स्क्वेअर, इट शूड सॅटिस्फाय दिस डोमेन और इट शूड सॅटिस्फाय दिस कन्स्टंट. सो व्हॉट विल बी द व्हॅल्यूज फॉर द एक्स डोमेन? विल बी 0, 1, 2, 3. दीज आर द व्हॅल्यूज फॉर एक्स. अँड व्हॉट आर द व्हॅल्यूज फॉर वाय? वाय इज इक्वल एक्स स्क्वेअर. सो वी हॅव टू मेक द एक्स स्क्वेअर ऑफ व्हॅल्यूज ऑफ वी हॅव टू मेक स्क्वेअर ऑफ द एक्स व्हॅल्यूज अँड दॅट विल बी द वाय व्हॅल्यूज. सो व्हॉट आर द वाय व्हॅल्यूज? 0, 1, 4 and 9. सो दीज विल बी द व्हॅल्यूज फॉर द वाय. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज आर्क कन्सिस्टन्स बिकॉज ईच व्हेरिएबल इज रिलेटेड टू अदर व्हेरिएबल इन सम काइंड ऑफ इक्वेशन. सो हियर एक्स इज रिलेटेड टू वाय. हाऊ एक्स इज रिलेटेड टू वाय? स्क्वेअर ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू वाय. So here domain of x is like this. So what will be the domain of y? Domain of y should be like this. So it is called as arc consistent. It means the domain of both x and y is a set of digits. So we can write like this. After that we have seen path consistency. Path consistency म्हणजे काय? समजा टू व्हेरिएबल चा सेट आहे x आणि x j. आता ह्याला आपण पाथ कन्सिस्टंट कधी म्हणणार आहे? जेव्हा एखादा तिसरा व्हेरिएबल असेल xm, हा व्हेरिएबल अशा प्रकारे असणार आहे की xi इज इक्वल टू a आणि x j इज इक्वल टू b आपण जर दिला असेल तर दॅट विल बी कन्सिस्टंट. वेन इट इज गोइंग टू कन्सिस्टंट? वेन इट इज गोइंग टू सॅटिस्फाय xi xm अँड xm xj. दॅट मीन्स xi xm it is consistent with xm xj. So the middle or the common variable is xm. So it will become path consistent. म्हणजे जसं a is equal to b असेल आणि b is equal to c असेल तर आपण अनुमान काढू शकतो a is equal to c. So like this, if two variable set is xi xj and the middle variable is xm, in such a way that xi xm and xm xj, okay, these should satisfy, these are satisfying the constraint. It means that xi xj, these are the path consistent, and that is applied to the map coloring in this example. After that we have seen k consistent. If there are n number of or k number of variables which are consistent to each other, then how it is called? It is called as k consistency. After that we have seen the global constraint. Global constraint म्हणजे काय? जर आर्बिट नंबर ऑफ व्हेरिएबल्स असते तर त्याला म्हणतो आपण ग्लोबल कन्स्ट्रेंट. सो दिस वॉज अँड दॅट ग्लोबल कन्स्ट्रेंट इज अप्लाइड टू द मॅप कलरिंग. सो ॲट एव्हरी कॉन्सेप्ट वी आर अटॅचिंग द मॅप कलरिंग प्रॉब्लेम अँड हाऊ इट इज अप्लाइड टू द टू फाइंड आउट द सोल्युशन. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट द इन्फरन्स इन सी एस पी. इफ यू हॅव एनी डाऊट्स एनी क्वेश्चन यू कॅन पुट ऑन द कमेंट्स. थँक्यू.